Good afternoon, guys. Welcome to this chemistry session. The first topic that we did after the COVID outbreak on this e-learning was solutions. So as you remember, the solution for a chemist is simply just a homogeneous mixture. So a solution has two parts. The abundant part is called the solvent. So in this case, the one that is abundant is the solvent, and the one that is least abundant is called the solute. So there are so many solutions from the three states of matter. As we said, you can have alloys as solutions, this air is a solution, soft drinks are solutions, but then the one that we refer to the most as chemists is the aqueous solution, which is a solution in which a solute is dissolved in water. So water, as you remember, is a universal solvent. So water is a polar solvent. There are also non-polar solvents. Like if you see, you put cooking oil in water, there's no dissolution. But if you put cooking oil in benzene, there's dissolution, because benzene and oil are non-polar, so they're able to dissolve in each other. But then water is a polar solvent because the H2O, the hydrogen, has a partial positive and the oxygen has a partial negative. So there's hydrogen bonding there. I'm sure I explained about hydrogen bonding. You can go and read some more. So the polar solvent dissolves polar molecules like sugar. Sugar is a polar molecule. And also salt, the table salt, which is sodium chloride. So these dissolve in water because they're also polar. They have an extreme positive and an extreme negative. So when we dissolve, so this is my sugar. I'll put it 1 teaspoon there. So one of the factors is that I can't just dissolve it, put it like that and start taking, especially that it is in cold water. I'll have to agitate or stir. So stirring is one of the ways of getting your solution. So this that we have here, we'll call it a concentrated solution. Maybe it's too sweet for me. I'm sure even you guys, when you go out, you can't just drink anything. You can't just drink anything. You're supposed to show your manners by drinking just a little. So if this is concentrated, what do we mean by concentrated? It means it has a bigger fraction of solute. So if there's too much solute, then your solution is concentrated. So to make the solution dilute, you dilute with water. So this is water. Then when you add water there, that's got a dilution. So one of the common things that you know is that when you dilute like this, the concentration is reduced. This, the one that was there was a bigger concentration. The one that's here now is a lesser concentration. But one of the things you note, that regardless of the dilution, the number of moles or the quantity of your solute is still the same, because all you have added is water. So that's why the dilution expression is concentration 1 times volume 1 equals concentration 2 times volume 2. Why are we saying that? Because when you multiply concentration times volume, you get the number of moles. So the factors that affect solubility, you remember, is temperature. So if this was water, this thing, it was at higher temperature, if it was water, then what would have happened is it would have dissolved easily. If you agitate, also the dissolution is affected. You'll go and read some more on the factors. So that is all about the solution. Remember that a true solution, even if I put it somewhere there, you don't expect the sugar to settle. And the particles, you can't see them to say there is sugar, there is what? Why? Because they are molecular or ionic in size. So that is what we mean. So thank you very much for this session. Thank you, guys.